Hello, Rohan. Where were you all these days?
Namaste, uncle. Actually, I was busy with the school project works. Please hold this.
Oh, very kind of your father. I was helpless without cash. I have to pay electricity bill urgently.
You could have easily made the bill payments through the digital financial services or digital payment. It is very safe and convenient to use.
I have heard a lot about it. Please explain it in detail. It seems interesting.
Digital payment or e-payment is a mean to transfer value from one payment account to another using digital devices like mobile phones or computers. It is considered a better mode of payment than the cash payment because it is a very convenient mode as it allows one to move around with minimal cash. Moreover, only mobile phone or Aadhaar number or a card is required. One can easily pay anywhere, anytime through this mode of payment as modes like UPI apps, USSD or e-wallets are operational round the clock. Many discounts have been announced by the government to encourage digital payments. For instance, full exemption from service tax is provided if payment up to 2000 rupees is made through digital modes. Moreover, 0.75% discount on fuel and 10% discount insurance premiums of government insurers are also provided. An automated record is maintained in the transaction's history, irrespective of the modes of digital payment. There is low risk to no risk in case of digital payment. Mobile wallets have low risk only if password is not remembered to unlock the phone. Cards are not operational without PIN. Besides, cards can be blocked in a few seconds. AEPs requires one's fingerprint. Thus, risk of carrying huge cash in our pockets can be avoided. Let us now discuss the major types of digital modes of payment. These are cards, POS, USSD, e-wallet, and AEPS. Let us explore these payment modes one by one.
There are three types of cards which are usually issued by banks: prepaid cards, debit cards, and credit cards. Prepaid cards can be used for limited amount of transaction and can be recharged like mobile recharge.
These are preloaded from a customer's bank account.
Debit cards are linked to the bank accounts.
These are issued by the bank to current, savings and overdraft account holders.
This card is used to withdraw cash up to the limit present in one's bank account or purchase goods and services at a point of sale or online.
It can also be used for domestic fund transfer from one person to another. Credit cards are issued by banks and other entities approved by RBI. Most credit cards have a cash advance option that allows cardholders to withdraw money from a credit card. But certain things need to be considered while using it. This is one of the most expensive ways of taking out a short-term loan as the cardholders need to pay back the money at higher interest rate. Presently, the average interest rate for cash advances is around 24%. Fees approximately 3 to 5% of the amount withdrawn also need to be paid. In most of the cases, no grace period is given and the interest is charged as soon as the cash is withdrawn. Cash withdrawals are almost always limited to a set amount called the cash credit limit.
RuPay cards, which is an Indian version of credit or debit card, It is very similar to international cards, such as Visa or MasterCard.
I have this card, but I don't know how to use it.
To withdraw money from an ATM, you need to insert your debit or credit card. Type in your unique PIN number, that is of 4 digits. You can withdraw money or even find out your bank balance with the debit card.
Can we also use these cards at the retail shops?
Yes, definitely. The process is as follows. Give the debit card to the cashier at the store. Merchant runs the card through POS machine and types an amount of the purchase. Then the consumer types in the PIN of the card. The amount of purchase is deducted from the user's account. A printed receipt is signed by the user and a copy is kept by both the merchant and the user. Finally, customer gets an SMS on his registered mobile for transaction completed.
Now, I can easily pay my bills of electricity, water supply and telephone through this.
Yes, of course. It can also be used for booking airline or railway tickets, to make payment at restaurants, for shopping at shops or online, to withdraw cash from ATM, etc.
Can you please tell me about the use of POS machine in detail?
Point of sale machine or POS is an electronic device used to process card payments at retail locations. A POS generally does the following. Reads the information of a customer's credit or debit card. Checks whether the funds in a customer's bank account are sufficient. Transfers the funds from the customer's account to the seller's account. Records the transaction and prints the receipt.
Mobile-based POS. Mobile-based POS or MPOS is a free point of sale and cloud-based solution in which the smartphone or tablet is used to ring up sales, manage inventory, and build customer loyalty. Demonetization drive has made retailers to switch from traditional cash registers to MPOS that provide complete retail management. MPOS offers individual and mutual benefits to consumers and merchants respectively. Through MPOS, salespeople can accept payments from consumers anywhere in the store. Consumers can easily make payments on mobile POS devices via credit, debit cards, or digital wallets. Both merchants and customers benefit from loyalty programs continuously integrated into the payment transaction.
Do we need to take some precautions while using the digital cards?
Yes, you should follow certain do's and don'ts while using these cards. Do's. At the time of receiving your credit card or debit card, make sure the welcome kit is in a sealed condition. Sign on the reverse of your card immediately on receipt. Treat your credit card as carefully as you would treat your cash. If you lose your credit card, please report the loss immediately. Always ensure that the card is swiped in your presence. Ensure your mobile number is updated and registered for instant transaction alerts. Inform change of address or contact details to the bank promptly. In case of an unrecognized transaction, report instantly to customer care. Register yourself for an online transaction password such as verified by Visa or VBV, enabling yet another safety layer.
There are certain do's and don'ts for creation of transaction password. Let us know them. Password must have at least 8 characters and at most 16 characters as the length. For successful creation of password, one should have a combination of numeric digits and alphabets. For example, it must have at least 3 numeric digits, or it must have at least 3 uppercase alphabets, or it must have 2 numeric digits and 1 uppercase alphabet, etc. Password must not be the same like the old password or login ID of the online banking channel. Moreover, it must not be the same for last 6 consecutive password changes. Password must not contain special characters or space. It must not contain repeating characters more than 2 and successive characters more than 3. For security reason, commonly used words like computer, internet, etc. are not allowed to set as a password.
Cut the card into 4 pieces before disposal at the time of renewal, upgradation or cancellation.
Get your card replaced if you have used your card in a high-risk country by calling up customer care. Please notify bank representatives immediately if the card is lost, stolen or if the PIN is disclosed to a third person.
Do not hand over your credit card to anyone, even if he or she claims to represent the bank. Do not disclose your card number, expiry date, and CVV value to anyone. Do not use your card on websites like gaming, pornography, lottery, gambling, and unsecured payment gateways. Do not write the ATM PIN on the card. Never give a photocopy of the front and back of the credit card to anyone for any reason. Do not sign a blank application form to be filled by an agent or bank representative later. Do not access your internet banking account or unsecure public computer. Do not use your credit card on any unsecure websites.
Before making any online transaction, always notice the address bar at the top begins with HTTPS and that there's a closed golden padlock. Do not use your card on any unsecure websites which lacks a lock symbol. This icon indicates that the site is employing an encryption technology during the transmission of your sensitive data.
Do not fall prey to mass emails or SMS attacks asking for credit card details. Never respond to any emails asking for personal details and card numbers in response to attractive sounding schemes from suspicious callers. USSD stands for Unstructured Supplementary Service Data. This service allows every customer to access banking services with a single number offered through a national unified USSD platform, that is NUUP, on a short code *99#. It can be used for payments up to 5,000 rupees per day.
*99# is a USSD-based mobile banking service from NPCI that brings together banks and telecom service providers. By dialing *99# from the registered mobile number, a customer can access all financial services. This service works across all GSM service providers and handsets.
What all things are required to have an access to this service?
For this, you should have a bank account, any mobile phone on GSM network, and a registered mobile number.
Yeah, I have all these.
But how can I activate this service?
Firstly, visit your bank branch for linking your mobile number to your bank account.
Soon you will receive UPI PIN or UPIN, which you need to remember.
It is quite easy. I will get it activated soon.
Remember, the NUUP services are chargeable. Though TRAI has set a maximum limit of 1.50 rupee per transaction, one can contact respective telecom service operator to confirm the exact charges.
Can you please explain about the benefits of USSD to us?
Yes, of course. USSD is simple and easy to use. It is more secure than an SMS. It works on almost all GSM handsets. It does not require any GPRS connection.
That's great. But how can we use this facility to transfer the money?
It is a very simple process. Link your mobile number to your bank account.
Dial *99# from your registered mobile number. A welcome window opens up with the option of OK. Click on OK. You will get a window of various languages. Select your language by clicking on it. A window with options of bank details will open. Enter the required details. Further, you have to select your banking options by pressing the respective numbers placed adjacent to the given options. Then enter your referrals code, and you can skip this window by pressing 1 and click on option send. Next step is to select the desired option of sending money. After this, enter IFSC code of beneficiary, and then in next window, enter account number of beneficiary. Then enter the amount you want to transfer. Finally, enter your UPI PIN to complete your transaction.
AEPS stands for Aadhaar Enabled Payment System. This service empowers a bank customer to use Aadhaar as his or her identity to access his or her respective Aadhaar Enabled Bank account and perform basic banking transactions. It allows bank-to-bank transaction at POS or micro ATM with the help of banking correspondent, BC or VLE. The user has to seed his or her account with their Aadhaar number at bank or with the help of BC or VLE. User can do as many transactions at any AEPS point without any PIN or password.
It seems interesting.
What do I need to activate this service?
You require only 3 things. IIN for identifying the bank to which you are associated, Aadhaar number, fingerprint captured during your enrollment.
Please tell us about the various services provided by AEPS.
AEPS can be used for the following types of banking transactions: balance inquiry, cash withdrawal, cash deposit, Aadhaar to Aadhaar fund transfer, purchase at fair price shops. UPI stands for Unified Payment Interface. This system is meant for instant electronic payments through user smartphone. It is an advanced version of immediate payment service or IMPS. UPI facilitates round-the-clock funds transfer service. It authenticates the identity of the user using the phone as a tool. It works for 24/7 on all 365 days.
How can I utilize this service?
You need to have just two things to avail this service: a smartphone with UPI application and a bank account.
Kindly explain us about the working of this system.
Sure, it's a simple three-step procedure. Proceeding with step 1, download a UPI app of your bank. Then, create a virtual ID with your name or phone number and register with your account details. Remember, it's a one-time process. Now, to start with the second step, add the item to be purchased to your cart. Then go to Payment Options and select Payment through UPI. Provide your virtual ID to the merchant. Initiating with step 3, you will receive a pop-up window on your phone's UPI app requesting your approval for online purchase. After entering the security PIN, a confirmation of successful payment will be sent to your phone.
But do I need to share my bank details for utilizing this service?
No. UPI eliminates the need to share user's name, bank account number, IFSC or bank branch. It also eliminates the use of physical tools like debit cards. There is no need to use multi-step processes like net banking. It is very simple application and can be used by anyone. It provides instant and secure authentication and can be initiated anywhere. It opens up the pathway for a completely cashless digital society. It can be used to send a request for money like an invoice. Customers can also use UPI to make online payments of utility bills and school fees.
Which mobile app should I download to use this service?
You can download Bheem app, developed by National Payments Corporation of India or NPCI. Bheem or BHIM was rolled out in an initiative to enable fast, secure and reliable cashless payments through mobile phones. BHIM is interoperable with other UPI applications and bank accounts.
Can you please tell us about Bheem app in detail?
Yes, sure.
The main feature of BHIM app include checking balance and transaction details, sending and receiving money using QR codes, allowing payment of 10,000 rupees per transaction and 20,000 rupees for 24 hours. Sending and requesting money via payment address, sending and requesting money to mobile number. Sending money through MMID mobile number, sending money through IFSC code account number. Making merchant payments using pay and scan option. Sending money to Aadhaar number. Transferring fund to any bank account. Advance registering for payee and the beneficiary's bank account number is not required. Transferring money instantly and anytime. There are certain limitations of BHIM app or Bheem app. Only one bank account can be linked at a time. Only two virtual payment addresses are allowed. By default, first VPA is linked to your mobile number.
How can we use this app?
You need to follow few simple steps to start BHIM app. Firstly, visit the Google Play Store and search for the BHIM app. Select the BHIM app from the app list and install it. After installation, click Open to start BHIM. Then, select your language and click on the Next button. Again, click on the Next tab in the subsequent windows. Click on Let's Get Started button. Verify your mobile number by clicking on the Next button. Then, set up your passcode and confirm it. After that, select your bank from the list and click Next to continue.
How can we send money using Bheem?
For sending money using your VPA or bank details, click on Send option. Enter VPA of the beneficiary. Then, click on the Account plus IFSC option. And then enter the account details of beneficiary.
Can we even collect money using BHIM?
Yes, definitely.
To collect money, click on the Request button. Again, enter the mobile number or VPA of the person from whom you want the money. Enter the amount and click on the Request tab. Then, the payer would get a notification in his smartphone to accept or reject the payment. The payer can also use QR code to make the payment. Follow few simple steps to set your PIN. Firstly, click on the Bank Account option. Then, click the Set UPI PIN option. Finally, enter your bank account details, submit it.
E-wallet stands for electronic wallet. It is a type of electronic card used for online transactions through a computer or a smartphone. An e-wallet needs to be linked with the individual's bank account for making payments. Its utility is same as a credit or a debit card. The objective behind promoting an e-wallet is to make paperless money transaction easier. Let us glance through the features of the e-wallet now. E-wallet is a type of prepaid account used by a user to store money for future online transactions. The account is password protected. User can make payments for groceries, online purchases, etc. through this account. E-wallet has two main components, software, information. The software component stores personal information and enables security and encryption of the stored data. On the other side, the information component is a database of user details. It includes their name, shipping address, payment method, amount to be paid, credit or debit card details, etc.
It seems interesting. But how can I use this e-wallet?
It is quite easy. You just need to download the app on your device. Then, sign up by entering the relevant information and you will receive a password. After that, load money using debit or credit card or net banking. After shopping online, the e-wallet automatically fills in the user's information on the payment form. Once the online payment is made, the information gets stored in the database and is updated automatically.
My father is a merchant. How can he use the e-wallet to accept payments?
In case of merchants also, the first three steps are as same as for the normal customers. After that, declare yourself as a merchant and start accepting payments.
Wow, that's so simple.
Can you please tell me that? what do I need to start using an e-wallet?
Yes, sure. You require only 4 things. A bank account, a smartphone, 2G or 3G or 4G connection, a free wallet app.
SBI Buddy. SBI Buddy is an e-wallet which can be downloaded by following few steps. Firstly, visit the Google Play Store and search for the State Bank Buddy app. Then, click on the Install tab to download the app. After installation, open the app and select your language. Then, enter your details to sign up. After that, enter the OTP received on your registered mobile number. Then, set a 4-digit PIN and confirm it. Finally, turn on the button to accept the terms and conditions of the app and submit it. Log in by entering your PIN. Click on the Add Money option to add money to your wallet. Enter the amount you want to add in your wallet. Select the mode of payment and click Continue. Next, you can make payment by entering your debit card details. Click on to generate OTP option. Enter the OTP received on registered mobile number and submit it. Similarly, to send money, click on the Send Money option. Then enter the contact number of the beneficiary and click to continue. Enter the amount you want to send and then continue. Finally, enter the PIN and click Confirm to send the money. While using an e-wallet, certain things are need to be considered, such as use password and pattern locks for mobile security. Don't share your e-wallet credentials with anyone. Don't load your e-wallet with high amounts. Many merchandising stores still not accept e-wallet. Cyber security. While using these digital services such as cards, money transfer apps, e-banking facilities, etc., there is a provision of cyber security to protect your personal information or data. Cybersecurity is the technique of protecting computers, networks, programs and data from unauthorized access or attacks that are aimed for exploitation. Cybersecurity is about building confidence and security in the use of ICTs so as to ensure trust by the information society. It aims at the reduction and prevention of threat and vulnerabilities and having in place policies for protection, incident response, recovery, data assurance, law enforcement, and military and intelligence operations. Cybersecurity touches practically all citizens around the globe. It provides wide opportunities in human development as well as in achieving better integration in the information society. It also supports wider access to knowledge as well as to the development of policies and strategies. There are certain do's and don'ts of cybersecurity that remind us all of the actions we must take to remain vigilant. Do make sure that when you connect to a wireless connection, you are connecting to the proper network, otherwise known as SSID. Don't assume that because the name may sound similar that it comes from your trusted source. Do use passwords that comprise of uppercase, lowercase letters and special characters. Don't use familiar names or numbers like that of your family members, birthday, etc. Do take advantage of dual or multi-factor authentication. For example, many websites now offer securities beyond just a username and password, such as smart card PIN or even user-selected security images that one recognizes upon login. Don't use username and password only when other options are available. Do maintain a list of passwords in a safe place and change them at least quarterly. Don't keep the same passwords for longer time. Do keep your corporate passwords separate from your personal passwords. Don't keep reusing your company passwords for your personal password or vice versa. Do make sure that your computer is loaded with the latest patches and virus signatures. Don't assume that the virus detection software works perpetually with computers. Do use cloud data systems to upload and share non-confidential data. Don't trust friends, family members and associates with using your personal computer in your absence. Do backup data onto removable media and store in a safe place. Don't assume someone else has the responsibility to maintain and protect your data. Do check emails carefully to ensure that the source header is from a valid address. Don't fall prey to clicking a link to malicious websites that load malware into your computer. Do establish a relationship with your reputable cybersecurity firm. Discuss policy and procedures in advance to keep your company safe on the internet. Don't wait until you are confronted with an incident to seek advice.